Story for what we're doing today. Who's my story about? Humpty Dumpty. Humpty Dumpty, right? Yes, this is Ode to Humpty Dumpty, since we are going to be playing with eggs today and hoping that we won't have a Humpty Dumpty scenario. I thought this, what happened to Humpty Dumpty?
He falls off and then he splats.
Yes, he splats. That is the perfect word for today, splats. Yes, and we are going to try to prevent our eggs from splatting, right. But so I thought we'll start with this, and then what's going to happen is Aaron, who is our Mr. Science and the egg dropper for today, he will kind of talk about what the rules are going to be. They're pretty simple, but we'll talk about that, and then we'll head outside and we'll get started, okay? All right, so Ode to Humpty Dumpty. By Harriet Seifert. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty, what happened?
Had a great fall.
That's right. He looks like a very smart Humpty Dumpty, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Not very smart, though, for sitting on a wall. All the king's horses and all the king's men
couldn't put Humpty together.
Right, exactly. He looks very sad, yes. Doctor, doctor, hurry quick. Humpty Dumpty's very sick. It's so sad to say, but I know quite well, bandages won't mend poor Humpty's shell. We had another book about that, remember, where they tried some tape and gum? I can't remember all the different things. The baker brushed with the flour paste, but he knew his efforts were a waste. Humpty's shell is badly broke, and he's losing all his yolk. What's the yolk?
That yellow stuff,
right. With needle and thread, the tailor arrived, but he knew that Humpty had not survived. He put on his glasses and began to shout, "Humpty Dumpty's insides will soon be out." The king knew Humpty would never get better. He cried till his eyes got redder and redder. Norma Jean Foote, creative and smart, that's Norma Jean, knew how to mend a king's broken heart. So let's see what she comes up with. What's the first thing?
An egg house,
that's right. She asked a builder from down the street, "Can you build an egg house all tidy and neat?" "I'll build an egg house all tidy and neat, a perfect place for the king's friends to meet." So that's the first thing. What did they do next?
A nice statue, that's right. She found the sculptor, Harold von Bleek. Her eyes filled with tears as she started to speak. Make us a statue from perfect white stone of a happy Humpty nearer the king's throne. So that's the next thing. Humpty Dumpty trees. Then she said to the gardener, Reginald Leaf, we need something growing to soften our grief. Said the gardener, Miss Foot, I want you to see, I've shaped a beautiful H. Dumpty tree. All right, what's next?
Humpty Dumpty
slide. Yes. The gardener's assistant knew what to make, a Humpty slide by the side of the lake. We'll have a playground all tidy and neat where the king's children can frolic and meet. It's sideways though, isn't it? It looks better this way. All right, so anything more? Ah!
I know this.
Humpty Dumpty ice cream, that's right. A committee planned a Dumpty museum. The cooks concocted Humpty ice cream. The seamstresses stitched Humpty-shaped pillows. The gardener planted more H. Dumpty willows. They're going overboard now.
Yeah.
Yeah. The town crier called, come one and come all. There's going to be a great Humpty ball.
What's that?
It's a party, right? They're having a big party. You're invited to dance, to eat, and to sing. We'll all honor Humpty and cheer up the king. An appropriate shape, nice and round. He is, you're right. That is correct. So the shape wasn't quite right. Is that oval or round? Yes. The statue was finished. The house was all done. The gardeners looked perfect in the bright sun. Oh, the gardens looked perfect in the bright sun. Everyone fell silent. They formed a huge ring. They sang Ode to Humpty, led by the king. And here is the Ode to Humpty. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. We thought that Humpty would never fall. Happy we were as we passed by to see Humpty Dumpty framed by the sky. Humpty Dumpty had a kind face. He always behaved with honor and grace. We said Humpty was our national treasure, who looked down on us with unending pleasure. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. We cried and cried, and we heard to mutter, oh, wonderful Humpty lies in the gutter. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. He couldn't be saved, though we tried, one and all. Now we have Humpty in house, song, and tree. Humpty now lives in loving memory. The end. That is the ode to Humpty. Yay! All right, an appropriate story for today.